Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this week's edition of CineKid Television Theater. I'm Bob Clark, the Executive Director of CineKid Enterprises Incorporated, and I'm so pleased that you could be with us for tonight's program. For the next 30 minutes, you're going to have an opportunity to share with us the talents of our young people who range in age from 7 to 17 years. They're boys and girls, teenagers, who come to us from 40 neighboring communities, and this is, in every respect, their television show. To begin with, last week, the police arrived at the Carter household, and what a surprise. The detective was a dead ringer for Gary Clinton. Why? How? Join us now for the Clintons.
A device that will let me listen in to telephone conversations.
A wiretap? Isn't that illegal?
It is. Only if you're caught.
Okay, all right. Now let's go back. Tell me everything from the beginning.
Well, Linda came over. Wait a minute. Let me explain it to you. You see, I was there. Chip and me, we were in the elevator, you know, the glass one. And Chip kind of liked it, so we went up and down a couple times. And then Chip wanted a drink of water. So we got off at the third floor, and I figured he'd be all right. And that's when I went downstairs to meet Don. And he didn't come back.
I see.
After a while, we told the security guards at the mall. And then they called two policemen. That's when they called you. But we did look around for him for a while.
For a few hours.
Yeah. And then Sandy.
Yeah. I tried to get in touch with this mom on the payphone. And well, I feel like it's all my fault. If I just want to try to reach her, none of this would have happened. I feel so responsible.
Sandy, we told you it's not your fault.
Okay.
She thinks it's her fault.
Okay. Well, do you think it's possible that he's still back at the mall?
No.
Well, then, do you think it's possible that he met someone there, like a relative, or maybe he went to one of his friends' house?
No, we all planned to come back together, and he knew that.
He would have told me.
Well, did he ever run away from home before?
No.
Oh, Mom! Come sit down. Mom, this is Detective Josephson.
Evening, ma'am.
Chipper would never run away from home. Neither of the boys ever would.
Ma'am, we already have a description of the boy.
Chip.
But what we really need is a recent picture of him.
His school portraits are in the other room.
That's great. I'd like to see his room, too.
Sure, right this way. Thanks.
Is there something wrong?
No. It's just that you look like this person I know. Hey, Don. Is something wrong?
Yeah, are you sure you're okay, Don?
You guys aren't gonna believe this. But I know this couple that look exactly... The detective's in my brother's room. They're looking for my brother.
Yeah, we know that. We saw them go in, and your mother went with it. Oh, I see. He's talking his thoughts out, you know.
Oh. Yeah.
Okay.
I'll be back. I need some fresh air.
Now we're up to wiretaps and everything else. And where is little Chip? Okay, next week, the story continues. Right now, however, we're going to take a trip to that little log cabin nestled along the shores of that quiet lake under those spreading chestnut trees. Something was in that great big trunk that they keep in the living room. Let's see if we can find out what or who it was as we join Uncle Flywheel's workshop.
Cheese and relish sandwiches again.
What does that have to do with anything?
Well, ever since you were a little boy, whenever you eat those things, you have nightmares.
Uncle Flywheel, I haven't gone to bed yet.
Yeah, neither have we. And if you gentlemen don't mind, I'm getting awfully tired.
Yeah, why don't you go to bed, Andrew? Thanks for coming down.
Good night.
Good night.
All right. Tell me what happened.
Well, everybody went to bed. And then I went to check the lights out, and there it was in the middle of the living room.
Well, what did it look like?
Well, it was shorter than Jimbo, and had funny-looking eyes, and it was all green all over. And, looked kind of like, E.T.
E.T.?
Mm-hmm.
Did it want to use the phone? I'm just kidding. Go ahead.
Seriously, Uncle Flywheel. There was a monster.
Nellie, what is the matter?
He said there was a monster in here.
There is no monster. It was just a trick of the light or something. Now, everybody to bed. Come on.
How big was he?
It was shorter than you, Jimbo.
I could take him on.
Yeah, I bet you could too, Rocky Nut. To bed, all right?
I'll protect you, Nellie. Thanks.
You too. This time, I'll shut the lights off.
Nobody believes you around here. You'll see.
Are you having a good time? Come on, to bed, Bela Lugosi.
Who's Bela Lugosi?
Bela Lugosi, and it's time for bed. Come on. Monsters.
Now, Andrew has seen it, whatever it was. Next week, let's see if we can find out. Now for a little music. She was considered the female Jolson. And a few weeks ago, we were gratified with the response generated as we tried out a new series. Young Michelle Sakura of Warminster provided us with an interpretation of Miss Judy Garland in concert. This evening, Michelle will present one of Judy's most famous numbers, The Man That Got Away.
The night is bitter, the stars have lost their glitter, the winds grow colder, suddenly you're older, and all because of the man that got away. Done you, that great beginning has seen a final inning. Don't know what happened, it's all a crazy game.
Man that got away.
Thank you, Michelle. From the concert stage and the performances of Judy Garland, now to our news gathering division. Young Dave Trachtenberg, a few weeks ago in his series When I Grow Up, went to Norristown where he took a close look at a brand new Chuck E. Cheese Pizza Time Theater. Our kids are fascinated with this entire concept. It's rather unique, and we've had an awful lot of fun doing these particular programs, and we've eaten an awful lot of delicious pizza. But we thought it would be interesting to take a step back, as it were, and provide you with a chance to see David's first opportunity to work with the folks at Chuck E. Cheese. And this broadcast is a re-edited combination of some tapings that Dave did more than a year ago. Our host, David Trachtenberg, and his series, When I Grow Up.
Hi, I'm David Trachtenberg for When I Grow Up. This week we're going to be visiting the Northeast Philadelphia Chuck E. Cheese Pizza Time Theater. We're going to be talking again with Mrs. Anita Foreman, but first we're going to talk with the owner here, Mr. Murray Isidore. Mr. Isidore, could you please describe for me in a few words what Chuck E. Cheese Pizza Time Theaters are really like?
Sort of an indoor Disneyland. There's several things that you can do here, and they're very different. You can have dinner, you can have Sundays, you could listen to our different shows, you can watch TV on a big screen, you can play all different kinds of games, and you can play with our walk-around characters. But all in all, it's just a place where kids can just have a lot of fun.
What made you want to become an owner of a Chuck E. Cheese Pizza Time Theater?
It seemed to me that video games were a good business to be in, that pizza was a good business to be in, and that taken as a whole, it was a good business opportunity. But I think what sold me on it the most was when I took my kids to a Pizza Time Theater, I guess about a year ago, in Maryland. And I think an adult can appreciate it as a business, but you have to watch how a young child reacts to the whole store and see the magic, see the light in their eyes. Birthday party includes, obviously, food, drink, ice cream sundaes, tokens to play our games, a special skit performed by the Pizza Time players, a visit to the table by Chuck E. Cheese himself, and in many cases, a birthday cake. And it's become so popular that on weekends, there are birthday parties going on virtually from the time we open until 7, 8 o'clock at night.
Thank you very much, Mr. Isidore. Now we're going to be talking with Mrs. Anita Foreman. Mrs. Foreman, could you tell us what are the things that you do at Chuck E. Cheese's Pizza Time Theater?
I'm in charge of all the promotion, all the marketing ideas, and I guess my biggest job is to just convince people to come to Chuck E. Cheese's.
How many Chuck E. Cheese's are there?
There are about 175 in the country, and they are opening at a rate of 3 or 4 per week. They are also situated in Alaska, Canada, Australia, and pretty much of the country has been taken up with franchise agreements at this point. There are not too many places that haven't been bought up for developing.
What do the parents like to do here?
A lot of the parents make the kids leave so they can play the games. Parents of little children are sometimes so busy just watching the little ones that they really don't have much time for anything on their own part. And then we find that we have our oversized TV room with a large screen, and the daddies come in here and watch the ball games while the kids run around the store and play the games.
How does Chuck E. Cheese Pizza Time Theater differ from the average arcade?
Well, first of all, this is a family place. It's really not an arcade, and you can't call it an arcade. The atmosphere is a family atmosphere, and it's a nice, wholesome atmosphere. To keep it that way, we require that anybody under the age of 18 must be accompanied by a parent. We want this to be a family place, not just an amusement area, and kids can't just walk in and just play the games. Mr. Bushnell was very, very adamant on that.
What do you think the future is for Chuck E. Cheese and video games themselves?
First of all, I think that people have to realize that video games are here to stay. And if it can be in a controlled situation such as this and a wholesome atmosphere, I don't think people will have any objection. I think they'll like it. Secondly, I think that an important thing to realize is that this is the computer age, and this is what a video game is all about. Pizza Time Theater is right now developing educational-type games and educational-type computers for use in the stores, with the idea that today's generation should be familiar with computers because they're here forever. Right. And we might as well learn to use them, enjoy them, and get some educational value out of them, too.
Thank you, Mrs. Foreman, and thank you, Mr. Isidore. Well, that's it for this week's edition of When I Grow Up. I hope you enjoyed the show. Look forward in the weeks to come with an interview with the executive director of Cinecit, Mr. Robert J. Clark, Jr. Until then, I'm David Trachtenberg for Cinecit Television Theater. Good night.
Thank you, David, Mrs. Foreman, Mr. Isidore. A good presentation. And now, an opportunity for you to see our youngest kids in action. The series is called KidBits. And what it is, remember, is entirely the efforts of the youngest members of our organization. If you're a parent or a grandparent, I want you to consider what it would take for your child to invent, imagine, pretend a situation, to develop it, and then to perform it before a TV camera. It takes a little bit of effort. Our hostess, Miss April Richard, and the series, KidBits.
Hello, I'm April Richard for KidBits, and this week we have a special treat for you. A group of our Tyro youngsters and their staff leader have put together this clever picnic scene, together with a special treat to conclude it. Let's take a look. Well, that's it for this week. I'm April Shard for Kibitz. I'll see you next week.
Thank you, April. Thank you, kids. And now, join me as we go down the hallway, visit with Mark Weaver, and see what's on the CineKid bulletin board.
This week at CineKid's Family Movie Night.
My name is Bond. James Bond.
You're quite a man, Mr. James Bond.
Good to see you, Mr. Bond. Things have been awfully dull round here.
May I offer you a drink?
How reckless of me. I made you all wet.
Yes, but my martini's still dry.
The game is called Domination. I designed it myself. But my problem is I've never yet found a worthy adversary.
Friday and Saturday night, Sean Connery returns as James Bond, Never Say Never Again. PG Entertainment. What can I say? He is unmistakably a classy act. Come on out Friday or Saturday evening. Come on out both evenings if you're a James Bond fan. And in addition to watching some super fine entertainment, use this as an opportunity to tour the CineKid campus. If you're a young person between the ages of 7 and 17 years, you may indeed find that this unique organization is just the place for you. Give us a call at 659-4696. That's the first step to discovering the wonderful world of CineKid. I thank you for being with us, and until next week, same time, same cable channel. This is Bob Clark. Good night, and God bless.
I'm Jim Jolly. I play Chipper in the Clintons. In the story, Chipper gets kidnapped, but that's only make-believe. Remember, kids, you never go anywhere with a stranger.